Here we are in Rocky Mountain National Park. Lost.
I don't know where I am.
It's quite beautiful, though. You think those are the mountains we were sleeping next to?
Those, that wall right there?
I fucked it up.
I fucked it up, 20. Easy come be 2011.
We are in the wrong valley.
I hiked up to the wrong valley.
Wrong valley.
I did this once before in 09. I felt ashamed.
How do you feel now?
I pulled off the Colorado Trail without a hitch, but this is supposed to be a cakewalk.
He's letting it get to him.
Just show him where we're supposed to be.
Okay, okay. Shoulda, woulda, coulda been on this ridge.
Shoulda, woulda, coulda.
Now!
Welcome to Rocky Mountain National Park. I'm your guide, Joe Roman. What we have before us is the face. Todd Utne once tried to climb this. Infamous climber, Todd Utne. We're going to attempt it, 12,000 feet. This right here. He's told on his first campsite. He lay his little body right here. His body lay right here. And look up at the glacier for days preparing himself mentally. He would just sleep and eat because it's very mental. Not too much time to lose. It was right here. And Toro was first struck by lightning. Zap! He drops down. But he gets himself going and gives himself CPR, first time in court history. Attempt that's enough!
No, dude. Shut it off,
dude. Shut it off!
Torda was a young man, Eagle Scout, at the age of 12. He built a bridge to connect a land of people to the mainland that had never been there before, and that was his Eagle Scout project. Yeah, oh yeah, I climb with him, but not for the glacier. I wouldn't do it with him. You can't run that quick. It's July 19, 2011, and I'm 2 feet in snow. Sometimes I go up to my nipples, and then they chafe against my shirt because it's nylon, and that's what you gotta wear out here. Motherfucker, dude.
She said, "Get up the glacier, you bastard." He took a swig of whiskey. He took a gulp of whiskey, drank the whiskey. That right there was called the Utne Scoop. I'm about to face the Utne face. Here at over 12,000 feet, I can barely hear myself think. Very few men have ever even been where I am standing. It is excruciating. Let's get a closer look. At this very sport, Todd Utne ate his own leg to survive. As the temperatures dropped, he hid under it for shelter. And the snow began to fall. He ate it up. Let's get a closer look. It's right here. And against these very rocks, Todd ran out of bottled oxygen. He held his breath to the summit. Ah!
Are you bringing any snacks or anything? Oh my god. It's beautiful.
Damn.
You gotta be careful not to fall through here.
Yep.
This is where Todd Utne's body lies. Scarred and mutilated, burned and crucified, clutching in his little decrepit little hand
what he loved the most.
They found a Snickers bar. The only way we could identify his body was with the Peanutopolis tattoo that he had carved into his back. Damn you, Todd, for leaving us! So young! Damn you! So not so young! Thank you.